So when you first just look in this gray box, dissolving till LDP extrusion. This part is the initial new cycling process, meaning where you dissolve polymers, where you separate polymers, where you clean the polymers, and everything on the left side from the gray box dissolving is the pre-treatment of the post-consumer waste. All this part, the left side from dissolving till the green box, you don't need when you do post-industrial recycling. So this part we don't have today in our first industrial line because we use post-industrial waste. So how does the process work? When you want to use post-consumer waste, first you have to think about what you want to use, located, and which waste streams are basically available in this region or country. So we did our studies, of course, quite detailed in Europe, where it's quite harmonized already between the countries. And the next plant dedicated post-consumer will focusing on a mixed flexible packaging waste that is dominated by LDP. And this kind of waste then we get from sorting centers. And the first step is you make size reduction, like you see in the first blue box, meaning shredder. Then we do some additional infrared sorting, and then the biggest part is to clean it, meaning to get everything out what is not plastics, paper, organics, metals. And then after drying, you go in the solving process. The solving process, you can imagine it is like a big pot use PPA multilayer films. So when we dissolve all the so at the end you have a kind of suspension of dissolved polyethylene and non-dissolved polyamide flakes. And this mix of dissolved things and non-dissolved things, you have to separate in the liquid solid separation with a kind of centrifuge. And after that, you recover again the solvent, and then you can extrude those polymers. Here, of course, polyamide is not shown because this chart is for the post-consumer plant. But in our existing plant, you would have also a polyamide finishing and polyamide extrusion. What is also important to show here is that the last, or when we started with the whole project 4 or 5 years ago, the focus was separating polymers. But then we quickly found out that besides separating polymers, we can also use the process as a kind of cleaning and extraction process. Because once you have the polymer in a dissolved way, you have access to all the other things that are inside. Inks, color pigments, or additives. And that will be implemented in the next plant, that we also can extract colors and inks. We do that already on small technical lab level in our facility, and it works very nicely. Here you see some examples how.
everyone. Welcome to the video. This video will help you understand how, as an attendee, you can log in into the event and what all features you have inside the platform. So first, let's see how you can log in into the event. You will be receiving this kind of invitation onto your email ID. You can simply click on click to join inside the event. Otherwise, you can follow these alternate instructions as well. The other way can be, the organizers can share the direct attendees link and you can simply open that link and you will be landing on this login page where you have got the sign in options. You can use them to log in into the event. Now when I
also have some LDP versions of that. The polyamide goes in injection molding. So today we generate LDP and polyamide of our existing new cycling stream. And there you see some examples where you can use it. So also some